circle back to the command demand center, part two of this in the situation room. When we get into this Metroid dread situation on this super picture that we drawn, that we gonna be giving to one lucky viewer or subscriber with that Street Fighter 6. You understand? Get your hype. Don't be drawing without your hype music, man. What's up, man? Let's turn up. You understand? Let's get into this Metroid Dread situation. All right. What? Let's tell you where we at so far. Oh, my God. You understand me? Do you see that? Look at Dread. You understand? Look at Samus. You understand me? Let's get some light. Welcome back to the Command Demand Center. You see what's going down. Let's get our pencils. And let's get down to business. You need down to be down. Yeah, get your heart building together, man. Let's see what we're working with. You need, yeah, man. Man, it's going down. Get you down together on this music situation. Let's turn down a little. Yeah, man. We got a lot of turmoil, like I said, man. They boycotting PSN out there. Man, it's crazy, man. I ain't never seen so many people kill their subscriptions. Man, on PS, I know y'all see them dropping. I don't know if you can see that. But man, them people ain't playing. They mad about that Stellar Blade situation, man. They want that other suit. I think they gonna get it. There go that red there. That's what we need right there. That's what we looking for right there. And we got, we will be using of the pastelis tonight. Oh my God. Of the colored chalks. You understand me? Yeah, man, we about done with this. All we gotta do is this word at the bottom. And we gotta do that background, and man, we will be understanding me. You digging? What? Yeah. We ain't playing no games, man. We're gonna try to do that just like that picture, man. So when I get this picture out to that lucky subscriber, lucky viewer, it's over with, man. I'm gonna tell you something, man. No. I'm gonna tell you this here. Don't get cheated. If you win the picture, it's gonna be actually worth more than one of them posters because it's hand drawn. Ain't nothing out doing no hand drawing. No. Okay. Yeah. Don't get beat out your picture. You understand me? Yeah. Cause you know what? I'm gonna tell you something. Before I started this channel, I made a living doing what I'm doing now. And man, I would get ugly money for these pictures, man. So yeah, keep your picture, man. If you want to do what you want to do with it, but don't get beat out of it. Don't let nobody, hey man, I'll give you $5 for it. Yeah, man, bye. Holler, man. Later, man. Yeah. More like $500. You understand me? Yeah, this is hand-drawn, man. Ain't no price. Yeah, it's crazy, man. Yeah, you got to. Whoever get it gonna have an exclusive item, man, from the Command Demand Center. You dig? You understand me? Straight up, I'm telling you now. Yeah. I'ma price this at about $350-$400. You understand me? Depending if you a fan now, if the value of it go up, because some fans there's no limit on what they'll spend on a piece like this. You understand me? I'm quite for sure. I could have easily got about $450-$500 online. Posting this picture online. I already had offers for it before I even got. I always have offers, man. Yeah, cut it with the offers. You see me drawing it for the channel, right? Okay, man, you see it's a giveaway, right? Okay, yeah, man, why you wanna make me an offer, man? Yeah! You dig, man, yeah, don't do that, man. You understand, I'm not gonna, look like an idiot on the channel. Yeah, don't do that. Yeah, anyway. We're going to do this word down here. Now, some of these, this may not be the right pencil. So, we want to find the right pencil. We don't want to use any pencil. We want to give you, see, them Crayolas, man. Yeah, they no hose bar. Here we go with the, this is the other Crayola. I don't want to use them kind of pencils. I want to use, now this straight Crayola right here, red, that's what I'm trying to find right there. Yeah, because these, you don't want to mix your colors, man. You understand me? If you using a certain pencil, a certain kind of pencil, keep using the same kind of, unless you absolutely have to switch up. Now, if you absolutely have to switch up, you just gotta switch up. But no, we're not trying to switch up. We're trying to stay, keep, see, these are different pencils, dude. All of these are kind of different pencils. I got about 4 or 5 sets. I think I got about 3 sets of pencils. Let me get that. I think I got about 3 sets. Now this straight up Crayola red. Yeah, this straight. I'm looking for that orange red though. This straight up dark. Both of these are orange red. Okay, this is the same. Let's see what we're going. Yeah, man, they upset. Man, what? Yeah, they going. I'm like, what, man? Y'all Yeah, they messed up. Sony messed up. They know it too. They know it. I see them going back and correcting that problem. You understand me? You dig? Yeah. They don't want. Man, they losing too many subscriptions over that, man. They finna and let me tell you something. I was gonna say this, guys, for Command Center News, but let me go and let you guys know. You may have already heard. Xbox is finally doing a virtual reality helmet, man. Yes, them guys got it. Are in cahoots with Meta. So man, yeah, you know Meta licensed they operating system, they OS to any developer that made the helmet. So if they, you know, by paying them, they could use you can play the Meta Quest games on any. Company's virtual reality helmet. You understand me? Yeah, it's crazy. And who is that? Lenovo, is that Lenovo, I think? Yeah, Lenovo's making a headset. They got an Xbox headset coming. So yeah, I told you, these guys are gonna have to come forward. Sooner or later, they're gonna have to come. Yeah, it's the new movement. You understand me? It's the new movement, man. You understand me? Yeah. Whether we like it or not, things change, man. You understand me? That's how that go, man. You understand? We're gonna use this red orange because it'll fit in my device. This other pencil ain't gonna fit. And then, so I'm gonna tell you something, by using this situation that I use, you'll know if you're using a different color, kind of pencil. I mean, yeah, because it won't fit in that groove perfectly. You know, it'll slide out. You'll be like, okay, I must have a different pencil. It's a dead get, man. I'm telling you, I like, man. Okay, in case my newcomers don't know what I'm talking about, because there's always newcomers. I use this little big ink pen. And I break these pencils because if you try to color with these pencils the way they is, you're gonna sharpen all your pencil away. So I got around that by breaking it and putting it into this little hole. But these Bics are the only ones that have that little hole, and these just so happen to fit perfectly in that little hole. You understand me? So yeah, and I'm gonna tell you something. This is the only pencil that does that, the Crayola pencil. I don't know, I found another pencil that fits like this pencil fit perfectly in this hole, man. I'm like, what are you, man, what? Okay, yeah, so we're gonna do this word down here. Let me turn you guys in so you guys can see this. Yeah, man, all we had to do, I should have left that bottom piece on this picture, man. I'm kind of upset about that. Trying to rush the picture, I shouldn't have did that, but it was longer, and I should have left it like that. I should have left it longer, you know what I mean, because it was all ink anyway. So yeah, that's okay. It's still raw. People gonna get it twisted. I'm telling you now, they gonna think that it's a poster when they first look at it, whoever win. Watch what I tell you, they gonna think it's gonna be a, they ain't gonna know until you tell them, or they get all the way up on it, that it's an actual drawing. You understand me? Yeah, man. When I send this out, I'm gonna send it out with some plastic to whoever wins this. I'm gonna send it out with some plastic over it. Yeah, and some protections over it. And then I might send it in a protective case. So yeah. So it can't get damaged. while in traffic. You know what I'm saying? Yeah, so I want that. So you get it like I want you to get it. You understand me? And I advise you leave the plastic around it until you get a frame. Yeah, this is gonna be a collector's piece, man. This Metroid Dread, man. Yes, damn, this ain't any game. If I had to draw Zelda or Mario, yeah, on that same level, man. You understand me? Yeah, God of War, whatever, Kratos. Yeah, this is a AAA title, man. It's not a, yeah, this picture gonna be crazy, man. I'm gonna tell you that right now, man. And I can guarantee you, if you got somebody that like Metroid, they gonna wanna buy that picture from. I'm telling you right now. So get ready, man. And now if you in the resale, go for it. You understand me? Don't get beat out of it, though. Yeah. Yeah, we start our journey. We're gonna go ahead and do that Mega Man on Wednesday night to get that Mega Man X3 out the way, because we missed that video, because like I said, due to two schedules, man. It's crazy, man. So yeah, we're gonna do that Wednesday night so we don't miss out on that video this week. And we're gonna come back next week with Mega Man X4. If we miss that video, we're gonna do that again on Wednesday night, if we miss it. If we don't, we're gonna do it on this regular night, which is Saturday night. But we're gonna start that Stellar Blade walkthrough around the 20th. Okay, yeah. And then we're gonna just, yeah, we're not in a hurry, man. We're not trying to outdo nobody. Yeah, we're not. Cause you're gonna see, like I said, you're gonna see 1,000,000,000 walkthroughs on the game anyway. You know what I mean? I never try to outdo nobody, We're gonna take our time, you understand me? Yeah, we're never in a hurry. Yeah, I'm gonna be filming that also, okay? So this time with batteries. You know, I was upset, man, case I didn't tell you guys. I went to the mall, and man, I'm doing the video, the guys, they all on the video. They wanted to be in it. It was a good video too, man. And got home, man, and didn't have no battery. I was like, man, I talked to myself that whole time, man. Yeah, man, this gonna be, whoa, what, look at that. Look at that, man, what? You understand me? Now, when we do that background up, it's just crazy, man, you understand me? We hit that background up at the top. See, I'm dark red. I'm coloring it in dark. You understand me? So just like the picture. Now, when we color the top red, this gonna automatically stand out. The Metroid word, it's white. It's gonna automatically stand out. So, cause it's the only thing that's on the picture that's gonna be white. So it's gonna automatically stand out. You ain't even gotta do nothing to that. That's crazy. Yeah, man, you guys enjoyed that. That boy said, "Power Wave." That's what he said. He said, "Power Wave." Terry, well, I used to play that game, man. I used to play nothing but, I went through a phase with the Neo Geo. All I played was Samurai Showdown and King of the Fighters, man. You understand? Yeah, man. I had a real bout Fatal Fury for a minute, man. That was before games like Blaze Blue and Guilty Gear were even on the deck. Those games were the closest games to those type games, and I liked it. That's my type of games, man. I was a fighting fan. Always been a fighting fan. First in all games, my favorite games are fighting games. So I've always been a fighting game fan. You understand me? Ultimate Marvel vs. Capcom 1, all of Marvel vs. Capcom, Darkstalkers, and then here we go with games like Persona 4, Ultimax, Arena. Oh man, that was crazy, man. Yeah, and then they put that in Blaze Blue Cross Tag Battle, which we got, which we'll probably get into sooner or later. Yeah, we're gonna get back into that DNF Dual Strike one Friday night here. As you remember, when we picked that up, I was no good at it. We're gonna give it another try. It ain't gonna be too soon here. It's gonna be further on in the future. Yeah, but we're gonna get back on that again. Yeah, man, it's crazy, man. Yeah, we do the Japanese anime fighters, man. Cause this is, after all, the Japanese community. Yeah, you dig? You understand me? Yeah, we do all them games. The 2D, I like the 2D fighting. Sprite games, man. I done been through the 3D. Yeah, man. I done been through the 3D Tekken like games, man. You know what I mean? I done been through them. Ain't nothing wrong with them. I still play, man. I go like I said, all the way to Tekken 6. I got Tekken 7 in VR. With the PlayStation VR, you understand me? I play Tekken 7, but I don't even play with Law. I play with, like I said, Akuma, man. By the way, they just revealed that trailer, Akuma in Street Fighter 6. So yeah, whoever win that Street Fighter 6, man, yeah, you get that with this. So yeah, they just revealed his trailer. I don't know if you can get him yet, but yeah, we got a new character. Akuma, the return of Akuma. You understand me? Man, I seen some crazy combos with that guy on Street Fighter 6, man. You understand me? Yeah, it's crazy, man. Yeah, they changed the games a lot, man. You know, from the old school guys to these young guys. You understand? Which is cool. It's cool. But you're gonna find that old school gamers, they're gonna stick with the old school Street Fighters and the old school. Yeah, they ain't gonna too much dwell on it. They might play here and there, play that game here and there, but they're gonna naturally go back to the game they know. You know what I mean? It's always good to venture out, but yeah, we're gonna try to keep it. I remember when they came out with Marvel vs. Capcom Ultimate. Oh, I think that new Marvel vs. Capcom. Really, people didn't like that, man. I don't know why people didn't like that one. I played it was alright to me. But people didn't like that one, man. Everybody reverted back to Ultimate Marvel vs. Capcom. Yeah, man. I mean, yeah, don't get me wrong. They still ran their tournaments, and they still did. But how come the Ultimate Marvel vs. Capcom tournament is bigger than the new? You know. They changed the game. Sometimes they change the game too much, man. It's not the same game anymore. You understand? It's a different game now. You understand me? Yeah. Yeah, they put too much change on the game. Yeah, you gotta relearn that whole character again. You understand me? And I'm gonna tell you something, man. Guilty Gear, Blaze Blue, Guilty Gear, both of them games, I've been playing them games for like 7 or 8 years. If you gotta relearn your character on that game, it's gonna take you a long time. Cause them characters just don't got one or two moves. They got a lot of moves, each character. A lot of moves. You understand me? So you gotta relearn your character again. Who wants to go through that? Yeah. You didn't wanna learn them the first time. You didn't wanna learn them the first time. But you learned them. You understand me? This guy's going to practice. Go into practice mode, learn the character, man. You understand me? And then you spent all that time in practice mode on XRD or XRD Revelator or even an older. You understand me? But they're pretty much, the moves are pretty much the same on them games. But this new Guilty Gear, I got Strife. They changed a lot of stuff. They changed a little bit too much for me. You know what I mean? Yeah. I mean, that's just my views on it. I still bought the game. You understand? Because I like Guilty Gear. You know what I mean? But I'm gonna revert back to Guilty Gear XRD Revelator and XRD or older one before I play Strife. You know what I mean? Even though that it's the new one. You know, it don't matter to me. I'm gonna play. You're gonna tend to go back to what you know, man. You understand me? Every time. Especially if they change too much in the game. You know what I mean? Now if they don't change a lot in, yeah, this raw, you understand me? Yeah, man, it's crazy. That Street Fighter 6, we premiered it on the channel. My boy China Man and me played it. I played it with Taquamba Pearl. Go back in the videos and watch our premiere if you didn't see that, Street Fighter 6. And I figured out on Taquamba Pearl, I was playing it, that's a spectacular fight stick. And I figured out, they don't just do they uppercut. You can't just do the uppercut with Ryu and Ken. Your character has to be in the vicinity f- for you to do the uppercut on that game. You understand? They just ain't gonna go up in the air about it. No, no, no. And I said, you know what? Yeah, they just changed the game, man. You know what I mean? And that's okay. Now that you know that, and you got hit about 15 times, and you almost lost the match thinking they did. You did, because you're used to Street Fighter. You understand me? Yeah, let me get out of here, man. Man, look at that. You understand me? What? Okay, yeah, that's what we looking for. We looking for that red thread. You understand me? Yeah, it's over with. So we got that done. And that's what we want to do. We want to get this real dark. Now, we're going to have to go at the top with that background with some orange and some red and some ink. Because we got them guys up here at the top of this picture, man. And let me go get this, rig so I can show you guys what I'm talking about. Exactly. We got these guys up here, and you see where it's dark. We're gonna do that with the ink, with the circle shade. We're gonna do that with the ink. We gotta get that in there. You see how it's a little light down here? It's just not straight up red. We're gonna get all that in there, man. And then you see they light up. So we really don't have to do nothing to them, because when we make all that red, they already inked in. We just got to color that around them, and then that's going to automatically look like that because we didn't color nothing in here. You see what I'm saying? Yeah, man.
Yeah, it's crazy, man. Yeah. See, yeah. It's over with. Yeah, man. It's going to be crazy, man. And like I said, I'm going to dress it up for you when you get it. You understand me? Yeah. It's crazy, you understand me? We're gonna put some pastels on here, and then we're gonna get out of here. So let's get our tissue on deck. You understand me? Let's get our tissue so we can spread some love, baby. Now these chalks, these are called pastels, man. And they smooth out colors for me. Or you could use them on backgrounds. They got all types of pastels, man. Some people draw straight up with the pastels. They got pastel pencils. You know what I mean? Yeah. They got these in all shape, form, and fashion, man. So we're gonna go over this, we're gonna go over our purple arm first. Yeah, man, like I said, welcome back to the Command D-Man and Ascenters. Man, let's get these out first. Again, we're gonna, and you know, you just, you know what I mean? You see that? Yeah. And it just like smooth out your color, make your picture look way more smoother. You know what I mean? So if you got any lines or anything like that in the picture that you couldn't demolish out the picture, it's just going to smooth over the picture, man. And make it just look that much better, man. Yeah, you understand me? Yeah! Now, you may not be able to see it that well on this camera, but I can see it. You dig! I can see it, you understand me? So, yeah, it's going to make a difference. Yeah, it's definitely going to make a difference. So, going here with the same colors, you know what I mean? And see how that smooth that out, man. That's crazy. That's going to smooth that out. It's just going to make it look more natural. You know what I mean? And it just helped the picture. You know, and then the pastels, they so raw, you can't see where they start or finish. You understand me? They just blend in perfect. But like, only a couple of spots on here need it. You know what I mean? If not too many spots on the picture need it. Yeah, that's crazy, man. Yeah, man. So, man, I'm glad you guys tuned in tonight. Thank you. Like I said, we on our way to 500 subscribers. Oh, my God. It's over with, man. I got an elite prize at 500 subscribers. Let me tell you that right now. Somebody's going to be real happy. You understand me? Yeah. So I'm going to make somebody day at 500 subscribers. I'm going to make somebody day. They're going to say, hey, man, you know what? I'm watching the command center from now on.
Oh my God. Yeah, it's over with, man. It's over with.
See, you can really see it with this black. Yeah. See, it'll smooth that out. And see, look at that. Look at that. Look at that. Look at that leg. No. Yeah, yeah. That just smooth all that out, man. And now you can't tell where that started or finished. Yeah, yeah, that's what I'm looking for. That smoothness. Now, you could have went in there and did that too with just by rubbing on the pencil. That's going to mark your picture, though. And you just could have went over the pencil with it too. But yeah, it just don't look bad. It don't look as good as the pastels look. When you, it just don't look good as the pastels. I do it with the pastel, especially if you new to drawing. Now, if you know what you're doing, go ahead in. How you going in? Smooth this out. We got some yellow up here. And then, now we can really get out on this head up here. On this head up here. Laying that all on in. Because we got this orange. Yeah, they snapping on the techno tonight. Oh my God. Yeah, I see them guys, man. I see them guys going back on that censorship and removing that and giving I see them guys going back on their young. Cause they losing too many people, man. I would. You understand me? I would. I ain't even lying, man. I would. I ain't finna let all my people get that one. Let's go in here a little deeper with this orange. Blend that a little bit more better over that pastel to the point where. You can barely tell where that starts and where that ends.
You are not the
physical. Okay? Pound, ping, pound, ping. Get your hype music. Get your hype music. Yeah, we just want to go in there, blend that in just a little more, so you can't tell where that starts and ends at. Then we're gonna go back in there with that red. Now you gotta be careful with the red, because the red is a darker color. You wanna be careful with the dark colors, because they'll mess you up. If you don't know how to blend colors, the darker colors, you want to go easy with them. The light colors, you can pretty much get away with mistakes. Not the dark colors. Once you get with them dark colors, see, that's going to start looking better and better and better. Look 100% already. Now you guys may not see that, but I see it. I see it, and it's gonna make a huge difference. Now I don't gotta go over this black because it's doing what it's supposed to be doing. You understand me? You need what? Yeah, it's doing what it's supposed to be doing. You understand me? Yeah, man. I'm gonna go over this yellow on this arm. Blend that in. That's gonna really stand out when the background, all of that light gonna stand out when we color that background, man. It's gonna lift off the picture. Yeah, yeah. I see, like I said, man, they always put Samus and Mega Man Mega Man, Zero, Samus, Spider-Man, they always put them in the background where it's dark, but then they be the whole picture, really. They gonna stand out of the picture. They gonna stand out on the picture. I draw them guys a lot. And a lot of their pictures are drawn to similar. They always put them in a dark background and they be the light of the picture. You know what I mean? Especially Spider-Man, man. Metroid too. Metroid, Spider-Man, and Mega Man, really. Yeah, it's crazy, man. Like I said, this picture here is the only picture I ever seen where Samus' gun ain't got a beam in, lighting up in. This was a, I'm like, what? I didn't notice that until after I was drawing the picture. I said, man, this has got to be one in a million. That gun, that cannon of hers usually is always got, that this part of her gun usually always is lit up, like she about to shoot. On every picture I ever draw, and I done draw a lot of pictures of Samus, that's usually always lit up. I'm gonna put the breast shade on that. Breast shade on that. Okay. Then we'll come back on this side. That's crazy. Yes, that's me. Fresh shade in the game. Gonna leave that light, that middle part, to where you can barely, look at that. Yeah, you understand me, you did. What? Let me zoom in on that, man. What? Y'all see that dread down at the... Y'all see what it is, man. It's going down, man. Yeah, if you really... Oh, it's going down. Look at that. Man, that's crazy. Look at the top of that hand. See, now it's blended a little way better. You understand me with the pastels? Hold on, let me get this right so I can move smoothly. Yeah, that pastels made that look way better than what it did. And we got that word down there. Let me zoom out a little bit. We got that word around there. Yeah, so the whole overall picture, when we get through with that top, watch how I make that Metroid white word. That white, the Metroid, watch how I make that, when the background get done, that word's gonna stand out. Yeah, it's gonna stand out when we get that background did. Yeah, and them Emmys in the background, you see them Emmys up at the top? Yeah, we gonna get them in just like we did on the picture. Thank y'all, man, for tuning in. Anime Sunday jumped off, you understand me? We got the bottom did, so yeah. Like I said, my main videos, Anime Sunday night, Tuesday night arcade night, and fight night Friday night. Very rarely do we miss them. The other videos are subject at any time to be missed. As I said, don't forget to like and subscribe. Y'all know what it is already, man. The next time we come back on this picture, we're going to start tackling that background. We will not get that whole background done in one episode. It's going to take us about 3 more episodes to get that background done. But once we get it done, yeah, here we come with Street Fighter 6, this picture, one of them GameStop pictures, and a $50 gift card to one of my viewers. Don't forget, we will be presenting another question if nobody gets that Namco question right before next Fight Night Friday night. My other question should be even easier. So, holla.